Hello everyone, welcome back to our Ostia Let's Play series. In the Common Sense patch in EU4, 1.12.2. And I think we will get an achievement in this run. In this episode, I mean. And that will be the City of Cities achievement. We need 60 development in Vienna. And we're also still looking for the... what is it called? The... One family to rule all achievement, and for this achievement we need von Habsburgs on 10, no, on 8 different thrones. And we can make use of this option of our vassals to get a relative on the throne. I think that's the easiest way to get this achievement. But therefore we need regencies. There are no regencies. We gain a free stability again. We are very lucky with these free stabilities. You want a marriage? Yeah, I take that. I need more marriages. We have 5 now. And I will rival Spain at some point, but not now. Are we still ahead on tech? Yep. So let's... improve a bit more here. This one and this one. We need 2 more and then we have the achievement. Just thought a Poland game instant achievement, Blundy. I think that's not the case anymore. They patched that out. I tried that already and I was too late for that. I know what you mean, but I think it's patched out. I already tried that in patch 1.12.1 or 2, I think. So we will be at peace for a bit longer. Try to get the Cities of Cities achievement. And then we will attack Poland again. And we have Rome now. It's court. Yeah, you got it like that and I forgot to take it like that, so I will take it on a legit way. How you should get it. Instead of those stupid tricks. Imports compete with Austrian quality. Gain the mercantilism. How much do we have already? We have 21%. What can we do else with our vassals? We can do this option. Then the liberty desire goes down, but that costs us prestige, so. That's no option. Every vessel is embargoing my rivals. That is great. Yeah, and if I click this button, they will not fight for me anymore. But we get more income. But I prefer that they fight for me instead of getting more gold. Let's force religion in Brunswick and in Frankfurt. You should not do this too much, because then everyone hates you. Let's get everyone back to Catholic. And let's take a draught of beer. Ah, very nice. But if he won't get the achievement this way, then the blackjack achievement, then I will just create to 21 client states at some point. I don't care. Then we end the game after that, but we have the achievement then. Nope, no marriage. Nope. And I will not give you trade power, Spain. No way. And we finally can convert Arezzo. 10 months and everyone is Catholic in my empire. Well, in my own lands, I mean. Still need to get these other provinces back to Catholic at some point. Okay, I'm going to check how many nations we have with 5 provinces or less. No, or more. For the blackjack achievement, because we should be very close. Let's have a look. Hainaut is 1. Holstein is 2. Brabant is 4, so that doesn't count. Brandenburg is 5. No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, Bosnia should have 5, yeah, it's 12, 12, 12, Anhalt, no, that's one province. 12, 12, 12, 12. Brunswick, 13. Pomerania, 14. Saxony, 15. Friesland is 16. Seventeen, Hesse. 18, Albania. Yeah, we need 3 more for the achievement. So we will give Gelre more provinces. Utrecht will get more, and then we need to give which one? Ragusa into Italy, I think. Then we have it. Okay, I take your marriage then. Let's get the this army to this border, and then we will attack Poland. Oh, Boki, you are back due to your internet speed. Well, what happened? Did you miss that we got Hungary now? Maybe that's something you missed. I don't know since when you were gone. Danish separatists. No, I don't want them. Kill these rebels, please. Oh, you saw that. Well, we eat France. I give some to Champagne and Hainaut. And we took some territories here. Also, Switzerland got a bit bigger. They have Cuneo now. This is the last episode for today. An alliance offer from Portugal. Yeah, why not? Let's take it. Let's Scandinavia peaced out with the Livonian Order. They did not take anything. And we have, of course, we can get another religious idea or admin idea. But I will take up. That's more important. No, I don't take more marriages. That's not needed. I need to kill the rebels here. And let's have a look again if we can get on the throne of a nation. Nope. Unfortunately, we cannot. So we have two claims here, and I think Pomerania, yeah, you have a claim here. You have these claims, you have this claim. So let's go to war with Poland. They will call in Novgorod and Lithuania, but that is not a problem for me. And this will be the war goal. There we go. And Spain will help as well. More army tradition, 50% now. That's a big army. Can we upgrade Vienna already? Almost. So we almost have the achievement. And now all of our lands are Catholic. We don't have anything to convert anymore. Let's take the fortress of Podole. Yeah, it's a level 4 fortress, so that's not that easy to get. But we have a lot of artillery, and that is helping us with a bonus plus 5. So sieging this with more than 10 artillery gives you a bonus of 5, which helps a lot. Yeah, my vessels are doing a great job here. They take out all the provinces and all the armies. Look at this, 133,000 troops. Just helping me. You can conquer the world if you want to, but unfortunately, that's another let's play as Spain. Ooh, that's a big battle here. I think there will be reinforcements here that will help. Yeah, there they come. Yeah, they were just in time. Oh, those little callers. Memmingen, Württemberg, Würzburg, Kassel, Barois. All these nations fighting for me. And Britain is not a fair rival anymore, so all my vessels cancel the embargo. This should be something I will do as well, but we don't have an embargo. No, not needed. Let's go to the next fortress in Bratislav. Okay, I think we get the achievement now. I'm going to upgrade the diplo, the production and the manpower. Then we should have 60 development, and that should trigger the achievement. So let's have a look. Yep, there we go. We have the cities of city achievement. That's one extra. I'm going to sign it on my note here. Well, sign it. I will just do a stripe through it. Okay, there we go. That's another achievement I wanted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to go in this let's play. Pick Vienna. Which means we could build another building here. Let's build a courthouse. Just build all the buildings there. Let's see how many achievements I have at the moment. 63 from the 145 is 43%. It's very easy expanding this way. And I think in the next peace deal with Lithuania, we need to give Ryazan to Novgorod, and then I think they can form Russia. What we need for the achievement, the guarantor of peace achievement. We need to guarantee the peace of France, which is possible now. It's also from the Ottomans. I think that's not possible at the moment. Let's have a look. What? Cannot ally with a rival. Oh, yeah, of course. So we have to cancel this as well before we can do that. Oh, and our siege is over. So let's attack some more armies in this neighborhood here. Where are you going? To here. Let's attack this army. Yeah, we are way much stronger. And let's occupy Crimea, the next fortress. Maybe we should release, not Hungary, that's too much, but maybe another nation. Let's have a look. maybe Kiev. Or Bulgaria, that's a good one. Then they can fabricate claims on Ottomans. So, Lithuania, I want you to give Ryazan to Novgorod. Yeah, I want to release Transylvania, but they don't have cores anymore. Oh, wait. Oh, only Wallachia. Wallachia is possible. But Transylvania lost their cores because it took too long. Unfortunately. Nogai is big as well. And I see that Castile is, or Spain is colonizing Australia here. Yeah. Portuguese Mexico is very big. Spanish Brazil is big. Easy battles. So, Lithuania, would you peace out for what we want? No, almost. You know what? I want war reparations as well. Someone in the chat says, if you can try and make Lithuania give Smolensk to Novgorod. Oh, Slomos. I don't know if Smolensk is needed. I don't think so, but if you said so, we could do this. So, then we give those two to Novgorod in the peace deal. And we take war reparations. Just to be sure. Yeah, if you would check that for me, that would be very, very kind of you. This is all of Novgorod, Sevastopol, Theodosia and Ekaterinodar. The Russian names of Crimea. We should not talk about that, right? I think that's not a good thing to do. Oh, crap. Oh, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. Yeah, but it's only money, so there you go. Let's take the next technology level. We can get a new government type, an absolute monarchy. Let's have a look at that. Should we change? Oh, and someone looked for me when Russia will be formed. Plus Moscow, Novgorod. Vladimir, that's here. Nizhny Novgorod is here, I think. Where is it? Where is Nizhny Novgorod? Oh, it's sieged. And that's it. So they should form Russia then, but they are reluctant. Well, I will give Ryazan to them. Maybe that will help. And Smolensk. Where is our army? Where is our oh, here. And teach it more land in the south of Lithuania. And Nevers, again, has no heir, I think. Yeah, but the king is very young. He will not die anytime soon. Trebizond, where is Trebizond? Here. No, also a young king. I will not take those personal unions. I think the chance is very small that we get them. So, Lithuania, would you peace out now? Nope. Oh no, this is, well, maybe this is not that bad actually, because we will lose our average claim, but instead of losing an heir, I will try this option. No, I will not try this option, we don't have the money. Bye bye, and he's dead, and we don't have an heir, and our king is 40 years old. This could go terribly wrong. You know what? Just get the royal marriages going with the countries that don't have an heir. You never know, maybe we will get it. They will not accept a royal marriage with me. And you? Okay, you would. That's one more. Nope, no peace. So, Lithuania, would you peace out now? Yes, you would. Okay, we give Smolensk and Ryazan to Novgorod. Maybe Russia will form. We get war reparations. Maybe some money. Yes. Okay, there we go. So, Novgorod is a bit bigger. Let's set the provinces to the countries I want to. This will go to Pomerania. This will go to Silesia. This one as well. This one as well. Brandenburg will get two of these. And the rest will go to Pomerania. Let's see what we can get. I will go for this peace deal, but we need to siege up a bit more of Poland, I think. Put Novgorod peace out? No. So we need to take all the provinces of Poland. So in 2 more years we can attack Great Britain again. So we can give Utrecht this region, Gelre this region. Okay, this is the end of this streaming day, and so this is the end of this episode. We will end it here for today. Thank you for watching. Give me a like if you want, subscribe to my channels, and in the next episode, I hope. Nah, maybe not. I think it will take more episodes that we finally get the Blackjack achievement. We need Utrecht and Gelre to grow a bit, and yeah, maybe Ragusa in Italy or something. Or I will just give them these four provinces. Maybe that's good enough as well. But that will have to wait until the next episode. See you there. Bye bye.